Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Assassin's Creed 2. With me, TapersCrazy, while we last left off, we headed into Rome to finally hunt down Mr. Borgia, and apparently the vault, which needs the Apple of Eden to open, is also in Rome, so what a happy circumstance that is anyway. So all that I do with this video now is just go away and see if we can go kill Borgia and then uncover what the big secret is. So let's get stuck into the game. Alright, kill Rodrigo Borgia without being detected. He knows I'm here. Don't try and fool me, game. I know he knows I'm here.
Visibilium omnium et invisibilium. Et in unum dominum Jesum Christum, filium Dei unigenitum. Ex patre natum ante omnia saecula. Deum de Deo, lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo vero. Genitum non factum consubstantium.
That's not gonna be Borgia. I think this is all a setup, man. I don't trust this game.
Proper nostram salutem descendit de celis. Et incarnatus est de Spiritus Sancto.
Too easy.
I thought I was beyond this. But I'm not. I've waited too long. Lost too much. Requiescat in pace, you bastard.
I don't think so.
Oh god, he's got a big glowing stick. What is this? That one scene from Rising of a Shield Hero.
I see. Kind of you to bring me the apple. Now give it here.
Vai a farti fottere.
Always the fighter. Just like your father. Well, rejoice, my child. For you will see him again soon. You will give it to me.
As you wish.
Oh boy!
Fascinating. An impressive power, this. But if you think it's going to save you, another thing coming!
Of course he can't assassinate him normally.
You are right to fear me.
Hang on, let me just... There's one thing that's bothering me about this, and I know that this is supposed to be like a super mega impressive final boss, but what is the absolute point if giving me all these tools to assassinate someone, if none of them are going to work on the final boss?
You cannot stop me!
And just make it come down to a final slugfest. It doesn't make sense to me. It makes it just feel like a final use your sword and try and kill him kind of thing.
But useless.
Can I use throwing knives, perhaps? Well, throwing knife worked.
No, you will not take this from me.
It's finished, Rodrigo. Lay down your arms, and I will make sure the end comes swiftly.
Really, Ezio? And would you give up so easily were it the other way around?
Why don't we find out?
Uh-oh. Yeah, don't pull it out. Please tell me that's a fake.
And now, to deal with you.
Thank you. To be honest, I think Ezio made some strange tactical errors there. Like, pulling out the Apple of Eden so he had easy access to it was a bit strange. Find the secret passage. While gravely wounded, how hard can it be? Yeah, there's one there, and I guess I just need to push these two in. What a simple puzzle. Assassinate Rodrigo Borgia and recover pieces of Eden. Okay.
What is this place?
What a labyrinth. Final boss room, anyone?
Open, damn you! Open!
It's over, Rodrigo. No more tricks. No more ancient artifacts. No more weapons. Let us see what you are made of, old man.
All right then. If that's how you want to play it.
Oh my goodness.
What do you even want with the vault, Rodrigo?
Don't you know what lies within? Or do you mean to tell me the great and powerful assassins didn't figure it out?
Figure what out?
God. It's God that dwells within.
You expect me to believe that God lives beneath Il Vaticano?
A more logical location than a kingdom in a cloud, don't you think? Surrounded by singing angels and cherubim, makes for a lovely image. But the truth is far more interesting.
Let's say I was to believe you. What do you think he'll do when you open that door?
I don't care. It's not approval I'm after. Just power.
And you think he'll give it up?
Whatever lies beyond that wall won't be able to resist the staff and apple. They were made for fulfilling gods.
God is meant to be all-knowing, all-powerful. You think a couple of ancient relics can harm him?
You know nothing, boy. You take your image of the creators from an ancient book. A book, mind you, written by men.
You are the Pope, and yet you dismiss the central text of your faith?
Are you so naive? I became Pope because it gave me access. It gave me power. Do you think I believe a single goddamn word of that ridiculous book? It's all lies and superstition, just like every other religious tract written over the past 10,000 years.
Are we killing this guy? Is this what's happening? Did we just strangle him to death? It's a crime of passion, you know.
You can't. You can't. It's my destiny. Mine. I am the prophet.
You never were.
Get it over with, then.
No. Killing you won't bring my family back. I'm done.
Dude, he's the Pope. Is it once he comes back to strength, do you think he's gonna go, oh, never mind, I'm good now?
Elegito. Requiescat in pace.
He's just gonna shank you in the spine. Go. Can we change his mind and go back? T-Bug! Alright. In Bocca al Lupo. Synchronized. And did we uncover our final hidden location? Feathers. Viewpoints. Feathers, treasures. Where's secret locations all of a sudden? I guess they don't matter anymore, you know? Oh well. Alright, let's just look into this chamber and see what's in here. A red triangle.
Greetings, Prophet. It is good you have come. Let us see it, to give thanks. We must speak.
Who are you?
Many names. When I died, it was Minerva. Before that, Merva and Mera. And on. The others, too. Juno, who was before called Uni. Jupiter, who was before called Tinia.
You are gods.
No, not gods. We simply came before. Even when we walked the world, your kind struggled to understand our existence. We were more advanced in time. Your minds were not yet ready. Still not. Maybe never. No matter. You may not comprehend us.
Are you talking to me now? See you, fourth wall!
You must.
None of what you are saying makes sense.
Our words are not meant for you.
What are you talking about? There's no one else here.
Enough. I do not wish to speak with you, but through you. You are the Prophet. You've played your part. You anchor him, but please be silent, that we may commune. Listen.
I don't know.
We were still flesh, and our home still whole. Your kind betrayed us. We who made you. We who gave you life. We were strong, but you were many, and both of us craved war. So busy were we with earthly concerns, we failed to notice the heavens. And by the time we did, the world burned until naught remained but ash. It should have ended then and there. But we built you in our own image. We built you to survive. And so we did. Few were our numbers. Your kind and mine. It took sacrifice, strength, compassion. But we rebuilt. And as life returned to the world, we endeavored to ensure this tragedy would not be repeated. But now, we are dying, and time will work against us. Truth turned into myth and legend. What we built, misunderstood. Let my words preserve the message and make a record of our loss. But let my words also bring hope. You must find the other temples, built by those who knew to turn away from war. They worked to protect us. To save us from the fire. If you can find them, if their work can be saved, so too might this world. Be quick, for time grows short, and guard against the cross, for there are many who will stand in your way.
The cross? I assume we're referring to the Templars. Perhaps?
It is done. The message is delivered. We are gone now from this world. All of us. We can do no more. The rest is up to you, Desmond.
What? Who is Desmond? I don't understand. Please, wait. I have so many questions.
Ezio, this is where your tale ends, I suppose. You're a small part of bigger things.
What the fuck?
Every player playing this game. Oh, come now. Come now. Nothing, you're not even going to put me out into the real world? That's always been a thing that bothers me about the Assassin's Creed games. Is there's this element of going out into the real world. Well, someone's controlling someone from the past in the Animus, and... I guess there's an element where I could come out of it and speak to the people on the outside, but that's just it. That it just takes me through history.
There's only about 10 minutes until I
meet
get.
All of my friends.
Oh, here we go.
Before they do, Desmond.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, Sean. I need you and Rebecca to get everything in here packed up and loaded into the truck. You and I'll deal with the Templars.
What? They're here?
It was only a matter of time before they discovered us. To be honest, I'm surprised it took them as long as it did.
Let's go.
Oh, cool. Last second killing spree. Alright, am I going to be kicking ass now?
So, what's the plan? We ditch this place and then what?
There's another safe house. We've got company.
Okay.
The truck's just up ahead.
Are you going to go kick some ass or what?
Mr. Mike. This is an unexpected...
Oh, you'll be arse off on the first game.
And here I thought I'd have to waste more men on you. Kind of you to save me the trouble.
What do you want, Vidic?
For you to come home. We miss you terribly. There's still so much work for us to do together.
It's not happening, Warren.
You continue to disappoint in every conceivable way, Miss Stillman. I saved your life once. Do you remember? And this is how you repay me?
You saved me so you could keep experimenting on people, destroying their lives. And for what?
Oh, this tired argument again. As I recall, you were there, at my side, every step of the way. Their blood is on your hands just as much as mine.
You need to stop him.
I'm on it.
There we go. Dealt with him. Where is he? Why has she got a banner? Has she got a sword or just a stick? I refuse to die during the credit sequence. Do you know the thing about them doing this, with this interactive credit sequence, is the credits are rolling up the right of the screen, but I can't watch them because I'm focusing on the game!
Uh-oh, Doc. Looks like it's just you and me now.
Enjoy your victory, Mr. Miles. Temporary as it is.
Desmond, huh.
I am evil!
There you are. Come on. Help Lucy into the van. Hurry, Desmond. We need to go.
Well, that continues the story, I suppose.
Desmond. Warren's gonna get what he deserves. I promise.
So what now? Where are we headed?
There's a cabin up north. We should be safe there. At least for a little while. I have to analyze those tapes from your session. Figure out what's happening.
And then what?
Here we go. I've got you all hooked up. Got a long drive ahead of us. Figured you might want to play around with the Animus on the way.
All right, but I got some questions first. I mean, what the hell was that in the vault?
What you saw proves everything I was afraid of. The Templars aren't our biggest threat. Not by a long shot.
So what, the sun is? What's it gonna do, cook the Earth?
I doubt it, but I don't know. There's been some speculation that the Earth's magnetic field is weakening. A sufficiently strong flare could flip the poles and cause a geomagnetic reversal. It's all theoretical, but if it happens, the planet could become geologically unstable. Very unstable.
It's meant to be the stuff of pseudoscience, but clearly something catastrophic happened to the people of the first civilization. And that woman, what was her name?
Minerva, was it? She seemed to think we were due for a second round.
So either way, we're fucked.
I don't know yet. We'll keep reviewing the tapes. And you can keep digging through your memories. Maybe there's more to discover.
All right. Guess I better get started.
Right, okay. I'm a bit nervous to start talking about the game in case any more dialogue pops up and it sort of ruins my train of thought, but I want to get the harsh shit out of the way first, okay? And I've been looking through this game with... incorrectly so, looking through this game with eyes of a present, okay? So my main concerns that I have with this game is, one, with it being a kind of repetitive with some of the stuff, and two, it just felt a bit clunky at times. You heard me complain through the entire game, particularly during chase sequences. This game's nailed down the idea of free running and free climbing in a low pressure environment, like climbing buildings, running through the environment. It's fantastic, but once it gives you this element, you need to chase someone or run away from something, or you need to do it quickly, I think the controls sort of fall over and don't really enable the player to do it. Because as you're sprinting, you've got to hold down A to perform quick jumps, essentially, over the environment. But that means Ezio, or whoever the player, or whoever the character is, has to attach to things that is near him. So you could be wanting to vault over a barrel, but instead Ezio will climb up a wall to his left. So I think... I hope they get better in future games, but I just thought it was a bit clunky, and it did take away from the immersion and the enjoyment of the game for me, but I can definitely see why this game's still going. I mean, there's an Assassin's Creed game every year, because if I played this at the time it was released, I wouldn't have been exposed to any of this before, I don't think. The idea of free running in a 3D environment, and essentially it is an open world, effectively, and the idea of being stealthy with assassinations and stuff, it's all something that appeals to us as gamers, I think, because we love doing, having choices, the ability to do things stealthily or just brute force them to an extent. Although I did think there was some hollow difficulty spikes in there, like surrounding that farmer guy with a million guards. Granted, it was important for the guy that was running the Florence, but I don't think it necessitated having like 40 guards around him, giving me one avenue of attack, really, imagine just shooting him from a distance. And the only other thing that bothered me was the final boss battle with Borgia. And I said this at the time, but what is the point of giving me the smoke screen, daggers, throwing knives, the gun, if all I can really use against him is the sword and just melee combat? I think they wanted to keep it epic, so they didn't want me to just get a quick kill on him. But I just think it detracted from everything I'd done through the game in that... learning all these other skills. But that's the harsh of the fact way. I thoroughly enjoyed this game nonetheless. I've always loved the idea of open world free running and climbing buildings, and you saw midway through the let's play my collectathon instinct just took over. I had to get everything in the game, which I still don't know if I've got. I don't know if I've got that secret location, because it didn't tell me. But yeah, it's very fun from a collectathon point of view, and it's very fun from once you're in a low-pressure environment sort of scenario. And I think the story does sometimes take a backseat, and that's for... And I think that just works. I think it works how the story sometimes takes a backseat. Because... And to an extent, I actually enjoy the story of this game, you know. It's time-skipped over 22 years, but... when I was reading about the game before I played it, a lot of the stuff in this is actually based on true events, so some of the characters in this game were actually real historical figures, and some people said that they learned a bit about the history of the Renaissance period, or basically Italian history around this time, just from playing this game. And I think that's an interesting avenue, that the historical element's true, or based on true events, really. Granted, Ezio and the assassins, I don't think, are real. I thoroughly enjoy that they've taken that avenue. I think they'll do it in the later games as well, like Ancient Greece. The first game was sort of an unknown period of time. The great crusade into the Middle East. This one was about Renaissance Italy, which, to be honest, I don't really know much about. My history is not that great. But I know future games. I think, is it the third one, which goes into the American Civil War? I'm interested to know. I'm interested to play that one just to listen to the story. Then there's one in Industrial Britain. There's one in Ancient Egypt. And obviously the latest one, Odyssey, is in Ancient Greece. So I am wholly interested to see what sort of historical events they take through and what their take on them is. And I think the first two games hit on time periods that's not really taught in. Well, it wasn't taught to me anyway. I don't know about anyone else. But I didn't really know about. So it wasn't really like mainstream historical events. Imagine one in World War II. That'd be crazy, wouldn't it? I don't know, bloody the Nazis have something to do with the Templars or something. Although that would be outrageous because the Templars was initially an American, not an American, a British sort of arrangement, organization. But anyway, that's pretty much all I've got to say to the game. I think it was a very strong game. I see why it continued the franchise and I had fun playing it. It was just periods where I got a bit frustrated and you know me. Anyone that knows my commentary style is I complain about everything. Everything's the game's fault. It's never mine. But take that with a pinch of salt. Normally, because I'm your average gamer, I don't play these games very well. So if I feel a mechanic's not going my way, then I tend to judge a mechanic before I judge myself. But which is something I'm working on. It's something I'm trying to get better at. Just and a lot of the stuff in this game was my fault. Like screwing up jumps and stuff. I just think that to an extent the mechanics of the game weren't geared towards helping me as a player do things in the way the game wanted me to. And of course, for some reason, the button mappings just didn't work out for me. Like showing me a green button with a random symbol on it does not tell me what button to press at all. Anyway, well, we got some Uplay points. Right, so is the game going to give me control so I can see if I've completed it? I would love to know. Right, DNA. Right. Is that one more secret location that's locked? That's bothering me. That is so bothering me. Okay, I did a Google, okay, and this has just wound me up, okay. This is... I think this is, if this is the case, then this is just Ubisoft being the most microtransaction-y, DLC-forcing purchase, corporate scumbaggery kind of way of thinking about it. I've not seen how much it is. I don't even know if it's free, to be honest. But I'm in Montenegro Villa, and I've come to this door where Google told me to go, and it says, unlock this map through the Ubisoft Club, and... This better not be something that I've got to purchase to effectively max out my DNA here. Because that is the ultimate heart clincher right there, isn't it? It's like, oh look, you've done everything in the game. We're going to save us this one last thing, so we're not going to give you 100% unless you give us some money. That's, that leaves a very bitter taste in my mouth. Anyway. Let me just have a quick look on Uplay and see what it is. Okay. Why? Okay, it was hidden on the Uplay store, okay. It was like an extra thing. But you didn't have to purchase it. You had to... Well, you did, but you had to purchase it with these Uplay points, which are like... If you think back to all the Xbox 360, the idea of GamerScore, you use them to purchase game content, which... Don't get me wrong, it's a neat idea, okay? Like... As you play the game, you earn points by essentially doing achievements. You earn points, and that lets you purchase more content for the game. But just give me the damn game, you know. I've paid money for the game. Give me it. Don't put things behind barriers and shit. I don't purchase a book and then get through chapter 2, and then a quiz pops up, and the book slams shut and goes, well, I hope you've been paying attention. You need to... answer these questions or you can't go on any further. We're going to hide this content. Or a chapter gets extracted because you've not read certain elements. I don't know. It's just like, It's just, why? Just give me the damn game. All right, let me in. Let me in! Let me in! It's just standard Ubisoft trying to innovate with video games, I suppose. It's just, I just wished it was back in the age where you paid money, you got a game, you know? You didn't pay money, you got a game, but with bits sort of chopped out. It just feels a bit, to me. All right, let's just get through this place then. Reach the ancestral chamber. What's this do? I was raised in a small house by the Venetian lagoon, within sight of a rough foam capped waves of the sea. When I was barely old enough to walk, I became a sailor, navigating the Atlantic first as an apprentice, and then while carrying cargo for my father's patron, Messer Marco Polo. It was a good life. Right, okay. I hope this is nothing too strenuous. I mean, we've finished the game. I don't want the finish of the game to be... I don't want the end of the game to be like... me climbing through one of these tombs rather poorly, I might add. Ezio, do you want to grab a hold of this? Oh, it's a bloody left one, not jumping back before. Skeletons! No one wants to see skeletons. Right, what about this one? One day while ashore in the harbour looking for work, I fell in love. She was barely 20, but when I looked into her eyes, the whole world was reflected back. Clearer and brighter than the sun. Apparently that's going to fry the earth, mate, so be careful what you say. After that, I still went to sea, but my heart remained on land with the girl, who had become my wife and our young son. Alrighty. One afternoon that summer, Messer Polo called me into his study. My father was already there beside an older man, dressed in a strange hooded cape, watching us. That moment, everything about my life changed. My father told me that he was an assassin. Removing his ring, he showed me a strange marking on his finger, explaining that our family came from an ancient order that protected and defended mankind. He paused, and then, when I didn't speak, Messer Polo stepped forward. He told me that a stranger in the hood would teach me, and in return, I would carry him across the Mediterranean to Spain. So began my apprenticeship with Dante Alighieri, and one that was to destroy every bit of happiness I would ever have. So this isn't even the start of the Assassins. I guess is this just the start of the Auditore bloodline? Perhaps it is. Oh yes, more jumping puzzles. Don't mind if I do. No. Of course it will be timed as well. Ezio, come on, wake up. Made it. Oh god, I just shit myself. This should let me out at any time, I imagine. Cool. Right, what about this one? In preparation for our voyage, Messer Alighieri met with me repeatedly. At first, our meetings were about purchasing supplies, but soon they became about higher things, about life, love, honor, and justice. He told me that society was set up in such a way as to control its members, to stop us from thinking, from seeing. Soon I could look past all the laws and illusions. I understood that mankind was being used by its rulers, that we the people deserved freedom. Yeah, let's just all have anarchy, no one listens to anyone. Just take what we want. Who is this Mad Max? It was then that Dante began showing me pages from a book that Messer Polo had brought back from the palace of the great Genghis Khan. The manuscript, the Codex, was about our order, the Assassins. Oh no. There we go. Right. What do we get out of this place? Well, I guess we can get up there. These didn't need to be on timers. This is end game shit. Oh, for God's sake. Where does the game want me to go? Where does it want me to go? Oh. It doesn't... Oh. Hey! I think I made it. I don't know, though. Our planned voyage never took place. While returning to Ravenna to pick up the remainder of his belongings, Dante died. Dismayed at the loss of my mentor, I went to inform my father and Messer Polo of the sad news. Before I could even speak, I was ushered into the study and my father, his face white, locked the door behind me. Shocked, I listened in silence as he spoke. Dante intended to take the Codex to Spain where it would be safe, but he was being watched. The enemy of assassins, the Knights Templar, still existed. I recalled the stories he had told me of the Templars and it all became clear. Dante had been murdered. The Templars knew about the Codex and they knew about us. Shaking, my father told me to take the Codex and leave for Spain at once with my wife and child. As Messer Polo ushered me out the door, he handed me a small piece of paper with a number on it. With this number, I could draw on his credit. More ducats than I had ever seen in my life at any bank in Italy. Alrighty. Ugh. So what am I getting out of this? It seems to be telling one huge tale of some guy that I don't know. Oh, bloody Nora. Ezio, you could always, you know, climb these things. Thing that's bothering me here, okay, is that why am I being challenged? The idea of getting this content is to play the game and then sort of get collect these points, and then the arbitrarily adding in these weird time trial things to say, oh well, you've earned this content but you've not earned it enough. I don't know, it's just kind of, it's just all wishy-washy to me. I use wishy-washy a bit too much than I would like, to be honest, but it just bothers me to an extent that I've had to earn this content and then I've got to earn it more. It's like, surely I'm not the only one that sees the strangeness around all this. I need to be opening these gates as I go through. Right. Okay, let's hear more about this guy's tale. We set sail that night, the ship filled with cargo to sell in the markets at Barcelona. At first all was well, then to avoid a coming storm we laid anchor in the Otranto harbour. Cloaked in darkness, the pirates came. I didn't see them until they were already boarding my ship. I hid with my family in the hold, pulling out the codex, and I ran the worn leather cover through my hands, then I broke the spine. The pages slid silently onto the floor. I scattered them into the chests, boxes and containers I was carrying to the market. The men who found us were drunk. I could smell it on their breath. When they asked for the codex, I knew who had sent them. Holding back my rage, I said that I had thrown it overboard. They started to laugh. Two held me down, still grinning, while the rest cut off my wife's clothes. She begged for mercy until her voice gave out. Once they were done, they threw her into the sea. That's horrible, man. They took my cargo and sunk my ship and left me, adrift, clinging to a piece of railing. I made it to the beach with my son. My wife's body washed upon the shore the next morning with the tide. What a bunch of assholes, man. Really medieval times. Freaking people are assholes. Oh, boy. They're really testing me, game. testing me. For God's sake, Ezio. The camera's not quick enough for me to do this quickly. It sort of lags behind. We made it. There we go. Open the door. I never saw the sea again. Making my way to Florence, I rented a small room and then visited the bank. I had memorized Polo's account number. With the vast sum I now had at my disposal, I went to Venice in disguise to find my father. I returned to Florence the next day. Both Polo and my father were already dead. From that moment forward, I collected treatises on architecture, studied the classics, and took vocal lessons. I adopted the name Auditore, impersonating a noble at the Florentine court. Accepted as one of their own, I took on the trappings of nobility and constructed this villa for me and my son. And then I hunted them. I raised my son to fight, to find the Codex, to kill Templars. Together we will regain the honor of my wife and avenge the death of my father. Two debts that would never, that could never be repaid. To the Auditore that reads this, remember that you are not a nobleman. You are not one of the deceivers. You're one of the people. Avengers. So I don't think this is Ezio's father. I think this is probably maybe Ezio's father's father, his granddad. Perhaps. I'm not entirely certain. Right, okay. And what do I get out of the deal? Money, this is endgame content. I hope it's something that strikes a chord with me. Just a few chests. I mean, I might as well get them. Anyway, I appreciate it. We ended the game a while ago. And this is just all post-content stuff. Post-main content stuff. So, yeah. I'm going to show you my DNA. And I'm not going to go for all my thoughts again. To a certain extent. And this is a point, okay. I was blaming the game for a lot of the stuff happening there. Despite it being mainly me that was screwing up. But I do think that the controls of this game are just clunky as all hell. In these time trial sort of things. It's just frustrating once you're telling Ezio to run up a wall like this and then jump off it. But instead, it does something like that, you know? It's just frustrating. It's very frustrating. Anyway, let me just blow this popsicle stand and see what happens when I get out of here. Memory synced. Family crypt explored. Huzzah. There we go. Paying respects. Synchronized. And I think that's everything. Let me just go check the DNA. I wonder what this was all about, this little area here. There you go. Right, DNA. Secret locations. Treasures, courier, assassination, race, beat up feathers. Ha! There you go! Assassin's Creed 2 completed. Fully completed. Oh, good grief, man. That was a very, at times, stressful game, but a fully enjoyable experience. Anyway, I'll have to end it here because I'm out of time for this video and indeed for this series. I mean, a 50-odd part is just ludicrous. I've learned a lot about editing doing this Let's Play. So hopefully all my future Let's Plays will be a bit more concise and sort of learn from this one, really. Anyway, thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next series.